It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you.
You know, James is a great leader, full of knowledge. You know, it's like having a coach, another coach in the room. You know, Joe, he brings energy each and every day. He's the one that will keep you laughing and keep the energy high. And JT, that dude, he hasn't seen the field a ton, but he comes in every day and puts in, you know, the hardest work and grinds, and he's one that you can count on to do whatever you need to do. And so we're going to miss all three of those guys.
My guys, Jason, I love you. Matt, I love you. EC, I love you. Y'all my guys, man. Y'all my dudes. I'm going to miss y'all. EC, I'm going to miss your cuts, bro. I'm going to need you to get me right again. You know, that's not going to stop at all. Matt, I love you, bro. You've been here for a minute. You've been here with me since 2018. You've seen each other grow, and I'm grateful for the man that you've become. And Jason, I've only been with you for about a year and a half, but you've taught me a lot of things, and the way that you work and your work ethic is something that I strive for in my life, and you've brought a different mindset to me, even if you don't think you have. Love y'all, I miss y'all. I hope y'all have a good life and career ahead of you guys.
Some seniors that are specific to my position group on the D-line are Earl Mariner and Lope Leotawa. I think one of the biggest things is just the friendship. In the D-line, we're a tight group, I would say. And those guys both bring a lot of fun, a lot of excitement, a lot of energy to our room. And like I said, they're old men, but they have a lot of wisdom. So it's been nice to have them around, and I'm gonna miss those guys for sure.
Coach Harvey always teaches us as a running back group to always be selfless, and Lope Nikotoa and Tyler Algier are great examples of it. You know, day in and day out, they come in and, you know, they don't do a lot of talking, but through their actions, they show us, you know, how things need to be done and how we need to come out and the type of mindset that we need to have each and every day when approaching the game, whether it's in, you know, workouts or in practice, and school and everything else overall. So yeah.
And you know, Drew's, as soon as I got here, I was a walk-on, I was a nobody, and he was actually the first kid to actually reach out to me. So I love Drew, he's a friend for life. You know, I'm excited for what he has in store for him. So I love you, Drew.
Gunner Neal, that's Captain Neal and Big Gun right there. It's been a huge blessing to be a part of the receiver room with those guys, seeing what they've done in their careers, and to come in as a completely different wide receiver and to come in with my brother, obviously, was something it takes, I think, mature grown men that they are to accept us and to be willing to let us ride with them. And the journey that we've been a part of has been one for the history books. It's been so fun to learn from those guys. The best part of it all is that when I look out to my left and my right, sometimes number 45 out there is my older brother, and it's been pretty cool. I don't know, I guess the more I've seen them talk about senior night, it's been crazy that I guess this is Sam's last year, but I know we talk about it a lot. It seems like we mention it every day, but it's something that kind of goes unnoticed because he is my brother, but this is his last year of college football, and we've been on this journey of life together for a long time, but this year has flown by from the time that we came back home to be with mom, and to being here now. We're playing Idaho State in your last game of Edwards Stadium, Sam, but I love you, and I'm thankful for this year that we've been able to spend together, and it's been an absolute blessing.
It's been a long day without you, my friend, and I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. We've come a long way from where we began. Oh, I'll tell you all about it when I see you again. When I see you again.
Yeah. boys, my dude. Last ride of the bell, man. Oh, that's sick. Look at how cute I was, bro. Look at how cute I was.
Come on, man. Last time, gotta go out. Wifey got me right. Wifey got me right. It's in the details. It's in the details.
Right here, he's a superstar.
No.
He's a superstar. Watch him tonight fall out. This guy.
Love y'all.
Love y'all.
Crazy. Last time.
Hey, don't worry.
Get all in, boys.
Last game, man. Last game, you guys. Family on three. 1, 2, 3.
Family.
Crazy how fast it goes.
Tyler shoots a gap and gets in for six. Goal line is screen. Algier makes the catch, needs a block, has it. 10, 15, 20, 25. Needs a first down, has it. Mopini has the 24th touchdown of his career and the second touchdown of his season. And Pepe Tanuvasa lurking and snatching that out of the air.
On the field with an interception by the defense.
Touchdown! So Darren Hall goes quarterback sneak on third and goal from the one. Hill. It's Hall to Hill, and the Cougars go up 27-0 with a PAT pending. As Jaren Hall sets up and throws to the left to Puka, there's a catch made at the midfield mark. Spins out of one and two tackles to the 40. Jaren Hall back to back to Puka. Hauls it in for six. It away from Shane Daly Jr. and the INT. Touchdown pass for Baylor Romney to Dallin Holker. And Holker has his second career touchdown and first of this year.
We need, we get a little restless from such and get a little worn down. Like a bull chasing the matadors.
That's another way to do it. Keanu Hill made the punt block, and the Cougs recover for a score.
Let's go, let's go, let's go. That's how we do, baby.
Hey, he just threw it out here lower in the booth today.
You don't want to run against
him.
He take care of
it. You don't want to put your head down with
him. I'm a little sad, man. It's over. It's crazy. Time flies, bro.
Last one, Idaho State. Sad leaving. Good place.
Hey, last year, man.
Last year,
big blessings. Man, Cougar Nation blessing us, man.
Love it.
Appreciate it.